Welcome back to the channel, good friends. Brian from Apex Detail. We're working on a late model Viper V10. I thought I'd take you along for the ride. It's time for another short vlog. This is going to be a multi-stage, a two-stage correction. Going to be doing a little bit of detailing under the hood, a little bit of detailing in the interior as well. And it's going to get a ceramic metal oxide coating. Being that the top is down as often as possible, we're going to clean and protect the interior materials as well. This particular Viper has a rather old paint protection film, which is a partial, and that means it doesn't cover the whole hood. It only goes up the quarter of the front clip. And we can bring them back to life. I'm going to show you that in this video. All boogered up from bug guts and some scratches and whatever else Mother Nature has thrown up at it for many years. And then we'll walk around and I'll show you with the swirl finder what kind of wear and tear we have on the clear coat. Plenty of clear coat to work with. This is like a Corvette, very hard, stubborn clear coat. And the whole body is fiberglass. There's a lot of room to bring this finish back to life. We look forward to it. We can remove love marks, swirls, staining, etching. And we're going to do a two-stage correction, a cut and finish. Before we get to the paint and the aged PPF, we're going to work on the engine compartment where lies this big beast of a V10. The engine compartment's really not too bad, heavily dusted, a little bit of grit, and we have the insulation under the hood here needs some TLC as well. Just need to be careful in these areas. The older vehicles, you have to remember, they're not quite as waterproofed as some of the connections in the newer vehicles, so we're not going to be spraying foam and using a pressure washer under here. It's going to be with the least amount of moisture as possible. Geon Fabric Cleaner makes easy work of the insulation under the hood here. We need to be careful. It's getting older, it's getting brittle, so a detailing brush with soft bristles just to agitate, and then we'll carefully wipe off with a microfiber. No forced air, no really aggressive chemicals or tools will be needed here. And this is what we're going to be looking for, this type of turnaround when it comes to cleaning it, reconditioning it without really disturbing the material. And then when it comes to the harder materials like the painted surfaces and the hard plastics, we're going to break out the Extreme Solutions Showroom Elegance, kind of an all-in-one waterless product, or rinseless product anyways. And it will clean, condition, and protect at the same time. Simply mist it onto the surface. We have the battery powered pump sprayer here, just on mist, no steady stream, enough to get the product on the panel so it can emulsify, lift some of the grit, and I can wipe it free carefully. And I will also use this product to clean up the hard materials such as the metals and the plastics in the engine bay itself, being careful not to bump against any vacuum hoses or really disturb anything in the engine compartment in the older vehicles. And then for the cherry on top, so to speak, Manette's Mega Shine, which is another all-in-one and also cleans, conditions, and protects. This darkens all of the hard plastics, makes them look richer, energized, restored, and also protected. I simply mist this into the compartment on absolutely everything, let it sit for 20 minutes. It kind of self-levels a little bit, and then we can come back and wipe off any excess, and there we go. We have a finished compartment looking good. Now we can address the paint protection film. And if it was up to me, I would get rid of the partial and protect the whole hood with the film, and also the entire front clip, the fenders, the hood, the headlights, the bumper, the mirrors, and the rocker panels. And maybe even best to film the whole vehicle. But that's not in the budget, that's not in this package today. So I'm going to show you how to bring them back to life. Some of the older ones that have etching and some defects. We're going to use the PPF Renew from Geon, team that up with a light polishing pad from Kakami, and we'll attach that to any dual action polisher would work. The PPF Renew has some surfactants and very mild abrasives, so it can remove minor defects and imperfections from film. Films are sensitive to heat, so the trick and key here is to keep that polisher moving, keep the speed down, and very little pressure, and you'll be perfectly fine. A couple trips around that paint protection film, you'll bring out some of the minor to moderate defects. The heavy ones are going to remain, but you'll see some rather significant turnaround. I'll show you a little bit later. So the portion on the fender right behind the headlight or above the headlight hasn't been done. You can see some imperfections. The reflection of the light is rather hazy compared to over here where it's sharp, and a lot of the imperfections have been removed. It brings this area back to life. Here is the drawback of doing a partial. You will see the line, especially in these older films, going across the hood, where we would recommend filming the whole hood. Now, they did do a rather good job wrapping the bumper, so we'll have to really scale back to some of the smaller polishers to squeeze in these tighter areas. Also, the headlights and taillights also have a tinted protective film, and they can be restored a bit themselves using the exact same combination and team. And really, in no time at all, we have the entire area that has been covered with the old paint protection film, kind of restored, brought back to life a little bit, has a crisper reflection, deeper shine, and we're ready to move on. I'm excited to get to the painted surfaces now, my favorite part, and just to show you how dull some of these areas are. And as the excitement slightly builds as we get to the color scheme and the painted surfaces here of the Viper V10, we're going to end the video here. I'll catch you in the next video of the series. I really appreciate you guys stopping by and enjoy.